So next we have Gary Shaw, right here, a founding member of the Indian Point Safe Energy Coalition, a member of, has been a member of IPSEC Leadership Council. Gary and his family live in Croton-on-Hudson, 5.5 miles from Indian Point, and he engaged this issue in February of 2000 when Con Edison owned Indian Point 2 and had a steam pipe rupture that forced a release of radioactive steam into the air and a release of radioactive water through the Buchanan sewer system into the Hudson River. Gary's going to speak to us briefly about Indian Point.
As was mentioned, I've been fighting Indian Point for about 13 years now. And in my experience, the people at Indian Point are terrible at preventing damage, and they really crank up stuff once the damage has occurred. Just in a very recent episode, in 2007, a transformer exploded in Indian Point 2. The NRC said, well, that's bad. You have to put in protocols so that it doesn't happen in your other reactor. Move forward 3 years, and the exact same transformer exploded at Indian Point 2, at Indian Point 3, for which Entergy was fined over $1 million for not doing that. And just this past week, another transformer at their Entergy plant down in Arkansas had an explosion and fire. So when you hear the term lessons learned from the NRC or from a nuclear operator, it's a load of crap. I'm going to read a little bit from a man named Paul Blanche. Paul Blanche spent 40 years in the nuclear power industry. He's a consultant now. He's been a consultant to the New York Attorney General's office in the opposition to relicensing Indian Point. He's been an expert witness in several contentions before the Atomic Safety Licensing Board. He's very critical of Entergy and the NRC, and he talks about things like leaks from buried pipes. But in a statement that he made in April of 2010 in an annual review of Indian Point, here's what he said about the current Algonquin pipeline. These issues, which he talked about the huge leaks and releases of tritiated water into the environment, these issues are very significant and pose an extreme risk to the general public. However, they are dwarfed by the unanalyzed risk posed by the natural gas supply lines for most of New England. Most people, including NRC and Entergy personnel, are not aware that these 30 and 26-inch diameter gas lines operating at about 700 pounds of pressure, well below what Rick was just talking about, traverse the entire Indian Point site from the Hudson River to Broadway and are located within feet of vital nuclear system structures and components. He goes on to say, nuclear reactors and major natural gas transmission lines are incompatible when co-located on the same site. So the very fact that the existing pipeline is a tremendous threat, and now they're talking about expansion, to me is very worrisome. When we talk about the threats, you know, everybody looks at those reactor buildings, but the reality is that the biggest threat from nuclear plants, or the largest amount of ionizing radiation material, is in the spent fuel storage. We have about 40 years of accumulated nuclear wastes, and when they talk about spent fuel, that's really a euphemism. It's high-level radioactive waste, many of which will be deadly for eons. Plutonium has a 24,000-year half-life. Cesium-137, which is one of the most prevalent radioisotopes out of nuclear plant operation, has a 30-year half-life, which means that it will be deadly for 300 years. None of us will outlive the cesium. What I have here is a map. The red area, this is Fukushima. This is the first 25 hours of the Fukushima release superimposed over Indian Point right there. So if there were a fire at Indian Point, and by the way, the spent fuel buildings are simply commercial construction. They are not reinforced the way the reactors are. The spent fuel pools themselves are built partly below grade, and they are reinforced, but the building that houses them are not. The regulations have been changed over years because no nuclear plant in this country was ever built with the idea that they would have to store the waste basically indefinitely. So now those spent fuel pools are well above the design basis for how many spent fuel assemblies should be in there. They're about four times as much. There's currently somewhere around 2,000 tons of radioactive spent fuel assemblies being stored at Indian Point. Chernobyl 4, which only ran for 4 years before it exploded, and it was a very different design than what we have here, but the result of an explosion at a nuclear plant is the same regardless of nuclear plant design. That explosion, after 4 years, has contaminated 10,000 square kilometers, which is about 6,000 square miles. Indian Point would be far greater. We cannot allow an expansion of gas pipelines near such a dangerous location. And if, by the way, there's blasting, there are a number of things that could happen, and it's something we simply don't want. The risks are of immense magnitude. And now my time is up, so thank you.